Hi everyone, kitchen's open.
Got that out of your system now?
I'm good.
Hey y'all, we have a problem. And it's a real big problem because the prop that I had is right here. Oops. Here's the problem. And y'all know me. It's a big problem. Big, fat, empty. So, Sheri Kennedy is here to help me fix this problem. This is Sheri. She is one of my favorite people. She's started as a mentor, became a friend, and then became a really good friend. And I'm so pleased that you guys get to meet her. Y'all miss her over there. She's here with me, so I get her tonight. And if you have never been here before,
I don't mean to cramp your style.
If you've never been here, over here, down here, say hi in the chat. That's the counterculture. They'll give you a warm welcome. They're who I call when I want to have a good time in the kitchen. I'm Dina. Silver Lining Homeplace is where we are with Sheri Kennedy. And we are making limoncello tonight. So, let's have a cocktail.
Let's, by all means.
What's the line? But first a cocktail.
First a cocktail.
All right. So tonight we are going to make a lemon drop martini. And I'm going to try to do this with, the finger. Sorry. This one. This one, not that one. All right. So what we start with is 2 ounces of vodka. But first I need to stop dropping stuff.
You can use these.
These are better to use, aren't they? All right. Let's get a couple martini glasses.
Got it.
Okay, folks, you know how to do this. Grab your knife, grab it like you mean it, get your fingers around it, choke up. And we're gonna do lemons the way I like to. We're gonna cheat a little bit today because, as you know, I've got a little bit of a finger problem here. So I don't wanna squeeze these like I normally would, but I am going to cut it 1/3. And down here. If you're wondering why I do it this way, it is because of the way the pulp sacs are arranged in a lemon. There's a video on that, and I'm gonna do my very first card. It's gonna be up here, but I'll point to that video. So there's 1, 2, and the cheating that we're gonna do is we're gonna actually use a squeezer just so I don't have to get my finger all up in these. So I need to measure out a couple ounces. So we'll start here. So Sheri, do you recall when we met?
I believe it was at the Seattle Dog Show. I can't tell you what year, I have no idea. But I think it was at the Seattle Dog Show down at the event center in Seattle.
Yep. Yeah. And it would have been the year Betty started showing.
Oh, was it before Betty started
yeah.
showing?
Yes. Yeah, that was before Betty, the before Betty times. And we laugh about that because Betty just didn't do the show thing very well.
Betty didn't like it. So, yeah, you know, you don't want to force a dog to be a show dog if they don't like it.
Yeah. Yeah. So, yeah, we met at the Seattle show in 2014.
Oh, wow.
And you were so helpful that day to a couple of wayward strangers wanting to enter the dog world. But now I realize that you're not as nice as I thought you were.
Well, you know.
You just recognize that there are two fresh bodies coming at you.
Yeah, I try to be on my best behavior here when I'm just meeting somebody.
And I think you influenced a $300 or $400 shopping trip that
day,
too.
Oh, well, yeah. You wanted to talk about grooming scissors, and, you know, I kind of have a thing for that.
Yeah. So Sheri is one of the premier Bichon Frise groomers in, I would say, the country. She would argue with me.
Oh, no, I don't think
definitely
so.
Definitely the Northwest. And anything that I know about a Bichon, she or someone close to her has taught me. Very, very grateful for the Bichon community that we have here. Everybody's super nice to each other, and it's a lot of fun.
Yeah, so, thankfully.
Yeah. So that's that story. But so yeah, it's been almost 8 years.
Yeah.
And they don't do that show anymore. So yeah. That's a whole new chapter. And you know what? This is not getting enough juice out.
I know.
No? There's a, no.
Oh, I thought it worked really well, especially without the peel.
No, it works stupid. So we do need two more of these.
Oh, okay.
So I am going to do it the old-fashioned way. In,
those are smaller lemons, too, than what you're probably used to.
Yeah. You afraid?
Yeah, I don't like lemon juice in my eyes. It makes my mascara run.
She doesn't want me to squirt her, y'all. Where's the trust in that?
Hey, I do it to myself, so why would I expect you wouldn't do it?
Drink. All right, that should be enough. So let's get our vodka going here. Oh, yeah. Oh. Let's go ahead and do that. Rim the glasses now that I've got some. Oh.
Sorry.
No, you're good. You're good. We're just going to drink a lot of this.
No, let me pour some.
Don't do the, you know that's going to not work. So what we do is just rim your glass with the, with any one of these lemons here.
These are already pre-peeled. You'll see why later.
Yeah. And then really nice touch on these that Sheri was trying to get me to pay attention to her on, but you know me, I talk and do my own thing way too much, is put these in the freezer for a few minutes and they'll be really pretty when they come out. And you know how I feel about pretty food. So.
Pretty, but not pretentious.
Yes, God. No kidding. We agree on simple peasant foods.
Yes.
Must be. All right. So these are rimmed. Get these in the freezer somehow. Maybe I should have eaten more ice cream this week.
Oh, always.
Okay. How much vodka do we need? We need 2.5 ounces of vodka.
Is that per cocktail or?
No, that's totals. Where did my little guy go? Oh, under the lemon that kept getting moved.
Oh.
You know how sometimes when somebody's in your kitchen for the first time, they don't know that they shouldn't be moving things?
I know, it's weird. I've cramped her style.
I have moved this back 3 times today.
And I haven't liked it, so I've moved it out of the way.
All right, so. Perfect. Oh, yeah, we're going to need that other one.
Yep.
See, look, you're solving all kinds of problems
yeah.
today. And I think this is the last we need of the board, isn't it?
Could be, yeah.
Let's get out of the way for a while at least.
So I thought this was interesting. It's gluten-free vodka, in case anyone was concerned about that.
When would it have...
No, it would have never had gluten.
Oh, that's too bad. I mean, not too bad that it wouldn't have had, you know what I mean? It's too bad that we've gone there. Wow. And we need some simple syrup. How about 1.25 ounces? No, that's not enough. Because we're going to double it. Which puts us at...
4.5. How much? 1.2. Oh, I was thinking 2.25. Never mind. You know, math is not my thing.
It's a good thing we have a cheat sheet for our lemon math.
I just
today.
Proved that.
All right. So, put your cheater on. Here we go. Whoa. Whoa. you could be so kind as to get the glasses for us?
Oh, yeah.
And I took the ice out to make room, so it should probably go back in.
Okay.
Thank you, darling. The problem with ultra-fine sugar, it's ultra-fine everywhere.
Gosh, just one step above powdered sugar.
It's like sticky powder.
We don't do sticky.
Oh, God. My Band-Aid is sticky now. Ugh. All right. Here we go. Get your Hawthorne.
That's called a Hawthorne?
Hawthorne strainer.
Oh. Interesting.
That's what the internet taught me.
I've learned so much from the internet.
You know, the internet is the reason I am not in jail. Because I make decisions based on whether I'll go into jail or not. And if it's a yes, then I have to go, well, crap, there's no internet in jail.
What is it? You look up, how many years will this get me?
No, I have that down.
I don't know if this is appropriate or not, but
I'm feeling it. You're feeling it? I'm feeling it. We're good. All right. Let's.
I don't mean to be overly anxious.
Let's go full fluff frontal here.
Salute. Salute. Oh, that is good.
You need to do that again. Right here, my friend.
Oh, as noisy as I could. That's really, really yummy.
Ladies and gentlemen, she likes it.
That makes my toes curl.
Oh, drink. All right. I need to see who's here. Let's take a look.
I need to put my glasses on because I'm old.
Hey, Tori. We've been looking forward to seeing you all week. Gretchen? Is it going to be amazing? Do you really think it's going to be amazing? Friends and family, Discord for Creators launched this week. Keely Dunn, check it out. And never forget this. All right. Rich, how you doing, pal? It's good to see you tonight. Adam. Adam and I used to work together. We worked together for like 10 years.
Not Starbucks. No. Michael, the other place.
Yeah, the other place. Yeah. Yes, Sheri did the cold open for us today. Hey, Vincent, thanks for coming out today. It's nice to see you here. Christine.
Hi, Christine.
Attempt from the pasture. Good luck. I hope somebody's internet is strong enough. Who's this handsome guy? Michael.
Hey, babe.
Here, do you need to show him your eyelashes again?
Oh, no. I got my lashes on.
I moved it. There you go. All right. Yes, likes taste like chicken. There's nothing offensive about them. Do it now. Subscribing is better, but you know, I'll take the like. Yes, it's really nice to see the new faces around here. Oh, thanks, Kiels. Yes. Yes, do the Q thing. Principal Walker, thanks for joining us. All right, we are caught up, everyone. Okay, so Sheri.
So we're making limoncello.
Yeah, so what do we do?
We get some lemons.
Do you wanna, should we walk through the whole process?
Sure, yeah.
So we wash.
We wash lemons. About 10 to 15 lemons. We don't need to, you know, you put them in the sink. You can get some of that commercial produce wash if you'd like. You can find it in the produce section of most stores. Or I typically just put them in the sink, fill it with water, kind of warmish water, add a little bit of baking soda, maybe a handful, a couple splashes of vinegar, white vinegar, and a little bit of dish soap. And I let them float around in there for about 10 minutes or so. Drain them off, dry, rinse them off, and we're good to go.
Okay. And then
And then, so what we do after that is we're going to peel them.
We're going to peel them.
And then they have to steep for a while, like a long while, but we'll get there. We don't want to get too far ahead, but the lay of the land is steep, and then we strain them, and we're going to mix them and then bottle them.
Right.
So let's get to the peeling, yeah?
Okay. There's a lot of different lemons out there.
Do you want to be on that one?
Yeah, that's fine. There's a lot of different types of lemons. I think I saw 3 or 4. If you can get Meyer lemons, those are pretty nice because I understand they're a mixture of a regular lemon and an orange. Have you heard that? I think that's what
they are. Yeah, that's kind of what it is.
So they may have a unique flavor. The first batch I did, I used Meyer lemon, and this time we're just using regular straight up lemons.
Cool. So, all right, so she's going to show us down here on the money shot, where it's just your hands.
So you want to peel 10, 15 lemons per bottle of alcohol that we're going to use. And there's not really
a little closer.
Okay. Not really a technique, but there's a what you want to do when you're peeling these is you want to avoid a lot of that white pith, I think the proper word is.
Yep.
Pith is a weird word, but you want to avoid all that pith. Get just the peel itself and avoid the white part, because from what I understand, that makes it bitter.
Yeah.
So we avoid the pith.
Don't pith me off. This is the, I'll be
a,
get bitter.
A pith-free.
Yeah. No.
Recipe.
And what she means here is, you want your lemon to look like a white lemon, and then she's got these really nicely peeled, or de-zested. Anyhow, there we go.
De-zested.
Yeah. So we're going to come up with something fancy to do with this. I think it's called squeeze them and freeze the juice for cocktails. Because
yeah.
I make
you
lot of those.
You don't want to waste those.
I make a lot of those. All right. So where are we now?
So now we've got 15 peels of 15 lemons here. These are smallish lemons, so I would definitely go with 15. If you get something larger, you might go with 10.
Okay.
And then we're going to add the alcohol. And typically what people use is America's favorite, which is Everclear. Where are we at here? Down here?
We're right here.
Yeah. Everclear. 190 proof. 95% alcohol by volume. Lightning in a bottle. So one 750 milliliter bottle.
So I think this is what we call lemon clear at this point.
After it steeps, we call it lemon clear.
Oh, it's just lemon clear and Everclear and peels right now.
Yeah.
Okay.
So you seal that up pretty tightly. You don't want any of the alcohol evaporating. And then we let it steep. We let it sit for about 4 weeks. The longer you let it sit, the better. Some people use less time. 4 weeks sounds good to me.
Okay. So 4 weeks later then.
Yeah. Weeks later, this is what we have. This is actually a double batch, so we're going to be splitting. This is 2 bottles worth of Everclear, and we're going to split this in half.
Okay, so you did 30 lemons for this particular batch.
Yeah.
Okay.
Yeah. Okay. So now we need to strain this. So do you want to hold
this camera now?
Okay.
So you know.
Do you want to hold this and pour, or do you want me to?
Yeah, I
want to
hold and let you pour.
So in here, I've got three layers of cheesecloth, and then I've got a
giant
coffee filter. Yeah.
And then in just a regular sieve.
Yeah.
Are we using this again?
This what?
That.
The bottle?
Vessel.
Yeah.
Okay. Do you need a spatula?
There's one behind me in the corner. Okay. This looks very golden.
Yeah. The longer you let it sit, the more yellow it's going to get.
Got it. Good. I'm goaltending
good
over
catch.
Here.
Okay, I may have to resort to my hands, which are clean.
Yes.
Let me do that.
Especially since we had farm work that we had to do this afternoon.
Yeah. Okay. Let's let that drip for a little bit here.
I'm just going to hold it.
Okay,
so.
So the first place I ever had limoncello was in Italy.
Yeah.
At an airport restaurant of all places with Michael's mother, my mother-in-law Marie. And I tasted that and it's, you know, nectar of the gods. You know, it's just good. So I tried making some of my own, and it's really, really quite easy. You're going to see here how easy it is. It just takes a bit of time, but it's really very simple to make.
So have you... This is one of those things that people think would be hard to do. And, yes. You know, so you're, I think, a lot like me, or maybe I learned it from you, to be very DIY.
I'm a DIYer. If I can do something myself... I will. I'll do it myself, and it's fun.
I'm gonna move to this cam here, okay. So just move with me, so they can see what we're doing.
I like doing stuff.
And you're self-taught in grooming dogs.
Yeah, yeah.
And handling mostly.
Well, yeah.
I've seen some of your carpentry projects. They're solid.
Oh yeah.
Yeah, Sheri's one of those people that gets it done.
I
There's
do still.
No doubt about it. Yeah.
Okay, this could go on for days.
It could go on for days. Let's call that good.
Yeah.
And is this clear enough for me to go ahead and just pour?
I think it is.
Okay.
So I'm going to move this around here real quick.
Okay.
Actually, we need this, but I need to rinse it real fast.
I'm going to look at some comments and questions here.
Okay.
Okay, disregard that question, yeah. We're washing first because, just in case anybody else asks, we're washing first because the peels are the key ingredient. We actually don't use the inside of the lemon for this recipe.
And you don't want the pesticides or whatever might be on there.
Yeah, that's a good point. Okay. You like that, huh, Kiels? Dope transition. Am I in the future now? Yeah, you're in the future. It's 4 weeks. We're past all this crap that we've all been going through for the last few days, and we are now 4 weeks from now.
And we're wearing the same clothes.
Yeah, but we don't smell the same. All right. Rach, how you doing? It's good to see you. Missed you. Look what I did. You see what happens when you leave me alone at the counter? Don't do that ever again, man. All right. So now what? We're doing... What kind of limoncellos are there?
There is straight up basic limoncello, which we're going to do. And then there's a cream de limoncello, which is a creamy version. And we're going to do both. So since this was a double batch, I'm going to split it into two so we can make two different types.
Okay.
So we need to... How do we do this gracefully?
We use a ladle.
Okay.
It's right there. And I would do one and one, right?
Yeah.
Or no, there's lines, so you can measure it that way.
Yeah.
So I like limoncello. I mean, I've used it in cocktails. And how do you drink it at home?
I like it straight up. I like it cold. I keep mine in the freezer. I like it really, really cold. It gets a little cloudy and a little thick, or as I call it, viscous. One of my favorite words.
It's a good word.
But I prefer it just straight up. The way God intended.
Yes. She likes it straight up, folks. Yes, Rach, that was my, that was the 7.5-inch chef getting away from me.
It went wild.
Well, it's interesting. I caught myself moving in a way that I normally don't. For some reason, I was moving away from the food instead of pushing it through the knife. And I actually stopped and I told everybody why this was a bad idea and you shouldn't do it. And then I kept doing it.
And then she proved why it was a bad idea.
Yeah, but like the baller I am, I got it all wrapped up and came back for another 30, 40 minutes on the show and finished it up. And, you know, some people didn't even know what happened. So there's that. I put it in cocktails, like I said. I've also, like Rach has mentioned, she's used it in desserts. I think at some point in December, I did a surprise dessert with y'all and did the... the pound cake with the, I put the pound cake in the toaster, or you can put it on the grill, and then you drizzle that with some limoncello, and then put blueberries and whipped cream on it, or creme fraiche if you've got it. That's really good. I just have been a little heartbroken since there's been no good limoncello in the house recently.
And homemade really is better.
Yeah.
It just, with that, you know, almost everything.
Yeah.
Homemade's just better.
Yes, so.
Okay, so we're gonna set that one aside.
Okay, so now what are we doing?
So now we need an equal amount of simple syrup.
Okay.
Which I'm not sure we have, now that I'm looking at it.
Yeah, it kind of looks like not. Do you want your beaker?
Where's the little one though?
The little one what?
The little container of simple syrup right here. Okay. This might make this might make up the difference.
So you need equal parts simple syrup, and how are you going to know you've got equal parts? Oh, you're going to put it in the beaker.
Yeah. Let's see how much syrup we have to start with.
Yeah, that's a good call.
So simple syrup is just 50% water, 50% granulated sugar.
Ooh, I think you're going to have enough to do 32 ounces.
Okay, let's start. So you heat the water and the sugar together just till the sugar melts, and then you just let it cool. Room temperature is fine. So I'm just using this jar to mix it.
So there's 32 ounces there. And then we need 32 ounces of this, correct?
Right. You know, I could have stopped right there, but that's okay.
I think you're going to like this kind better anyhow.
We will steal a little from this one.
Yeah. I think you're going to be happier in the end.
Than the cream one?
Yeah. Well, and the other thing we can do is I can make more cream than clear from my batch.
Okay, see how that went cloudy? That's pretty cool. That was like magic.
You know what that reminds me of is Turkish Rocky. And I think Ouzo does the same thing when you add water to it.
Yeah.
Because it's this really clear alcohol, and then you add water to it, and bam, it's a cloudy day.
Yes.
All right, do we need this anymore? And this? No.
No.
It's out of the way. All right, so then now we just bottle them up?
Yeah.
Do we need to mix this one first to make sure we know how much we have, or are you going to wing it?
No, we'll just wing it.
Okay. Hey, Nicole. Guild Mortgage is in the house. Thank you.
Guild Mortgage, that's who we use.
Really?
Yeah.
Look at that. See? Yeah. We have, Nicole, we got you covered. I think that was the fastest close I've ever gone through, period. So, thank you.
Okay. Let's try this one first. Well, you're going to have to hold those while I get the...
Trust me to hold this.
Yeah. Okay. While I get the ladle back.
She's also trusted me with scissors and dogs before, so... It shouldn't be a stretch. So now we're on the bottling stage of our lemon math. This
feels like science. beakers and...
Well, you know, God, this is a great sound. Where's Collie?
Is that coming through? I hope.
Yeah.
Sorry.
You just got lemon on me.
You can make wings and not get anything on you, but limoncello, I'm splashing it on you. So I made limoncello about 6 years ago, and these were the bottles that I used then. So they've been sitting empty for a long time. So that's good. That one's good. Let's do a couple more, and then we can put corks on them and seal them up. Shall we?
Yeah. Yeah. Okay. I was just holding that there for a minute.
Well, let me get a label on that one. And then where's yours?
Oh, and she's got labels. Well, I'll do mine.
Okay.
No, I just needed that for the prop to show that it was empty.
Oh, gotcha. Yeah. These are just labels I printed up on the printer. I drew this on paint. Remember paint?
Jeez. This is how far back we're going, folks. She just said paint.
Yeah. Microsoft, was it Microsoft
P.
Paint?
Yeah, with capital P.
Yeah, I would do that on Procreate. Right, yeah, now
we'd be in Procreate, yeah. And Canva, and
yeah,
all over it. Yeah. Okay, so yours has the swing top. Mine did the hinge lid.
This is a different bottle than what you have.
So Sheri gave me a bottle of this. Oh, gosh. I think it was in 2016. And it didn't take me that long to polish it off. Give me one of those little skinny bottles. Yeah. yeah, I made quick business of that, and then she gave me the big bottle,
and a healthy bottle,
and well, together in December we went through that. Thank you, Vlogmas. Slow down, Chief. Oh, we might have a problem.
No, we're good.
Oh, perfect. Scared me.
Okay. Okay, think we might get one more of these.
Oh, we won't know until we find out.
Well, let's...
You know, just try it.
Let's give it a whirl. This might be perfect.
Knowing you, it will be.
Oh, it is. Look at that.
Damn you. Now we're talking, dump that jug, Rich says. Here we go. All right. Okay. So that's our standard limoncello, right?
Yep.
Okay.
That's your basic limoncello.
So what kind are you going to make next?
This is creme de la limoncello, which I'd never made before, but I've seen the recipe out there on, you know, various sites and thought it sounded good. So give it a try. So it's the same basic mixture of, or I should say, what do we call this? Lemon clear, the steeped lemons. Yeah. And
so, yeah, this is what we're calling lemon clear.
Right.
Also known as your urine sample.
Oh, I wasn't going to go there.
You know, it also looks like apple cider.
If it looks like that, you're not drinking enough water.
Yeah, this is true. This is true. You know, it looks like apple cider or a good Pilsner. Okay. That's it. All right, full frontal. We're back.
So this one's a little bit different. With the regular limoncello, you go equal parts simple syrup and lemon clear. With this one, it calls for one part lemon clear to two parts milky mixture, which is milk and sugar. That's really all it is.
The milky mixture. It's the milky mixture.
So...
Can I help?
Well, probably. I'm trying to figure this out as I go here. We decided this is about 28 ounces, right?
We decided you should measure and I should shut up.
Okay.
Because you stole some?
Oh, yeah. It's only 24. Yeah.
Yeah. Yeah.
Okay. So 24 ounces. So we want 48 ounces of the other.
Because it's 2 to 1.
Right. It looks like I have way more than I need available here.
Oh, and it won't last 4 weeks either, damn.
The thing is, when you steep all the peels, you don't know how much you're going to get out of that, really, because some of it is going to evaporate just because it's alcohol. So, you know, I just wanted to make sure I had enough rather than too little.
We've got a couple questions coming in.
Okay.
Tori wants to know if you have to refrigerate the lemon clear during the 4 week waiting period.
No. No, just put it on a pantry shelf and you're good to go. Don't put it out, you know, somewhere it's going to get a lot of sun. Just put it somewhere in the dark. It'll be fine. Boy, these look quite similar. Okay, now we bottle this up. Okay. Unless there's any other questions.
Thanks, Rach. That's great to hear. Question, are you going to post the recipe for this somewhere like in the Discord? You know, I will put it in Discord first.
Yes.
Because, you know, it will go on the blog when the blog gets turned on. So yeah, I will be doing that on Discord first.
Yes.
What you looking for?
The other one of these.
It's right here.
Oh, okay.
And yes, Dee does have... Thank you, Keely. Thank you. You remembered. Thank you. I appreciate that. Yes, I do have a Discord server. And it is Rotter, in case anybody is wondering.
Okay, now where... It's just like my own kitchen. I don't know. I put things away as I'm working. Oh, I got it. It's the ladle.
So just while she's getting her bearings, you can see pantry cam with the, you can't really see it. I'm shutting up now. Back to us, because we're cuter than the pantry cam at the moment.
So this does look a little bit more creamy than the standard.
Got that?
Yep.
So I'm going to be planting seeds soon for starts. You're not going to need any this year.
No. No, I'll be planting cactus.
Sheri's leaving me. She's leaving me for Arizona here soon, and I could not be happier for her and Michael. This is super exciting. After how many years here?
My entire life.
Yeah.
Both of us.
Okay, that's good.
Yeah.
Don't go any further.
Yeah, my entire life, and you'd think I would be used to, I am used to the weather. It's rainy and gray and drippy and wet here a lot, and that's not my favorite thing. So I'm looking for sun. So we're moving down to Arizona.
Yeah. So where are you putting these without lids?
Just setting them over here for now. Okay.
So you have way too much milk.
Yeah.
Which means Michael and I can have cereal.
Yeah. Oh yeah. It's already sugar. It's got sugar in it already. Yeah. So.
How long will it last in the fridge?
In the fridge or, well, it'll last a long time. In the freezer, it can last years.
Yeah, I had my big bottle of it. The whole time I lived here. I know I had it before I moved in.
Well, I made it, I found a picture of that was dated 2015.
Uh-huh.
That's the only time I've ever made it. So that was...
Oh, so this is the second time. We're telling the internet that you know what you're doing on the second time. So 6 years. 6 years.
Yeah.
And that's a full 6 years because I didn't run out until in January. Maybe February even.
I saw you run out on your show. I saw you pour the last of it into a cocktail.
Yeah.
And that,
which is the impetus for today.
Exactly.
It was Dina without limoncello is not a Dina anybody wants to be around.
Gotta get on that.
It's better for everyone. Okay.
So you can see the difference here. One's a little more creamy.
Let's do that down here. There you go. And will this settle and be less cloudy after it settles, or is it just always going to be like that? God, my fingers are sticky.
Well, you know, since I've only made this once before, and I believe it does settle or clear out, because the stuff that you had just recently was more clear, wasn't it?
Yeah, it was. And I don't remember it ever looking like this. So maybe over time, or maybe over little bits of time, like 10 minutes time.
Yeah.
20 minutes time. So cool.
Yeah, I'm not really
sure.
And
do you know anything about the shelf life of the milk kind?
Personally, I would keep it in the refrigerator. Maybe about a year would probably be good. There are other milk-based alcohols out there, like Bailey's and other cream sort of alcohols that don't say anything about refrigeration at all. That just seems a little to me. I mean, I prefer that. You know, it's milky. I want it refrigerated. So, but, you know, a year I'm sure would be good. I'd drink it after that, you know.
We're a little free form about when things are expired.
I'm not going to lie. Unless it's got something growing on it, I'm going to drink it.
Yeah. I had some frosting out on the counter for like 2 weeks and I just kept drinking, eating it. It was fine.
Okay.
Well, it was cream cheese and, and butter and sugar. Butter and the sugar kind of made it all work.
I hear there's a shortage of cream cheese these days.
I'm not going to screw around with cream cheese.
I haven't noticed. Have you noticed that in the stores? That there's no cream cheese? Or
I have seen it once since the holidays.
Okay.
Rich is asking, what does that lemon milkshake taste like? I'm thinking it might be close to a lemon chest pie. I think it's going to be better, Rich.
Lemon chess pie.
We might need to try that. Damn it.
We got some lemons.
Are you coming back?
How much time we got?
Well, you know, I need to do a recorded video for next week.
There you go.
Which, by the way, folks, this is a good time to mention. We're at the 4 p.m. Pacific slot right now. Next week, we won't have a live stream, but I will be dropping a video at the regular time. And then the week after that, we're going to start at 5 p.m. Pacific. So just making sure that's out there. So the milk doesn't go bad, Tori. And hello, Eric.
That's pretty.
It's gorgeous. Pretty? It's really gorgeous. If you want to put here, right here. Do the Vanna shot right here. Get your eyes out of the shot. You got to have your eyes out. There you go. Perfect. You've learned. She knows to keep it in the same plane. I've taught you well.
I've learned that. Yeah.
Yes, I've taught you well. All right. So we got another one.
This could be the last one.
And then we're going to play with tools. It just keeps on getting better. Here we go. Rich, this is for you.
Okay. What do you think? Do you think it's going to overfill?
I don't know, man.
Or fill?
Just don't scare me.
It's going to be right on. No, it's not. It's going to be too much. Well, there's a remedy for that.
I know the name of the person that can fix that. Yeah.
Good.
Right here.
Should we cork some up?
Here.
No, wait. We gotta wait. We gotta wait on that.
Man.
Let's put some corks in these.
Okay.
Because we're not going to drink it all tonight.
Well, we could have that in my glass.
Well, just... Oh, this is sticky. It's all right.
Okay.
I can get through it.
I can't.
I don't
like
sticky.
On the counter.
So this one is self-sealed.
I don't believe it.
Bam, we're done.
Okay.
But these.
Oh, is there anything on over there? Here, we gotta unplug this. I'd feel much better if you were over there with that, because this will kill the stream if it takes too much power. It's a 100-year-old farmhouse.
Oh. Okay.
Or I can get you a... Yeah, no, let's go for it.
Let's go for it.
It can't pull that much power.
Well, there's nothing going on over here. The last time it pulled power, I mean, that this happened, we were toasting and cooking, and they're sticky. You want me to try some?
Yeah, they barely fit. I mean, I brought a mallet to kind of pound them in there.
She wants me to pound it, y'all.
These stoppers I got from Amazon, I'm sure you can use regular corks, which I did last time, and they were fine. And
then they kind of broke up a little towards right. the end.
Yeah, I dipped them in hot wax to seal it, and you know it looked cool, but it was a pain in the butt to do. So let me try to. Is everything gonna shake when I do this? Okay, hang on. These are synthetic corks, and I think if you heat them up a bit, actually, and I did that on a trial run, I forgot to do that this time, but if you heat them up a bit, the stopper will kind of soften up and you can get it in there much easier.
And well, then I guess we have some homework then.
Yeah.
Do you want to try to put it in one of the bigger ones with the bigger hole?
Yeah.
Okay. Too much girth, y'all. She's never gonna come back.
See, this one is not big enough.
Okay, Goldilocks.
I need something that's just right.
Just right.
This is not gonna fit over there.
It's not gonna. I don't think you should try to seal it like this.
Well, I can seal it just to go through the motions.
Can we at least try pounding again?
Yeah.
I want to pound.
Yeah. Put that over the top.
Do I have to?
You don't. Well, yeah. Okay. I mean, it's sealed. It's in there. It's just that the cork's not seated all the way down.
You didn't lube it enough.
But it's in there.
All right. So pretend that it's lubed enough. Yeah, that's not going to work either.
Yeah, it does. It does. I promise you it does.
She practiced.
I did.
Yeah? Mm-hmm. I want to show them. So it looks all official wine-like, y'all.
Let me seal it up. Heat seal it. It's going to make a little noise. Good to go.
Okay, wow, I'm impressed.
So you're gonna start gardening soon?
Yeah, I'm supposed to get out there and start planting the seeds. Yeah. Because, you know, the cauliflower, there's stuff that needs to get started. You know, and I'm kind of new at it. It's been 4 years, but anyhow, there's this, so. Are we done?
Yeah, we're done with limoncello, I'd
okay.
say.
All right. So, yeah, I'm going to do.
So, when does gardening season start for you?
December?
Oh. Well, we're way behind.
Well, no, planning.
Okay.
Because I do all the planning.
Okay.
Yeah. And then.
And before you moved out here, you lived in the city.
Yep.
And so you didn't start gardening until out here.
Yeah.
Yeah,
I had no clue what I was doing.
And now she's a gardener. And I've grown tomatoes. That's, you know, in a few things. But I remember a book that I said, maybe you should listen to this. I do audiobooks because I love to listen to authors narrate their audiobooks. And I recommended a book called Animal, Vegetable, Mineral. And
I remember. And it changed my life.
It's a great book.
Absolutely changed my life. Barbara Kingsolver and her family moved out
from Tucson, Arizona.
From Arizona.
Where I'm moving to.
And moved to the family home place. And actually, that's, I don't know if you remember, but that's where I got home place. Was she mentions it. I did that too. She uses the term home place in there.
Oh, and I didn't.
That's where I got it. Yeah.
Oh, okay.
Yeah. So they moved back to Virginia and little home in the holler, she says. And they, it's about, it's a great book. So first of all, Barbara Kingsolver narrates the audiobook. I recommend that's how, if you listen to this book, this is how you do it. If you read the book, that's great, but really listening to it is where it's at.
Yeah.
So it's a year in the life of this family who decides to be very mindful about where their food comes from. And most food they grew, or it had to come from, I think it was like 100-mile radius or something like that.
Yeah,
or,
they made a commitment for a year.
Yeah, yeah. So no food with passport. So they didn't have limes, I think, for a year. They didn't have any bananas.
Yeah.
Basically any tropical fruit they didn't have. They were looking, you know, trying to source things. And it made me go, okay, I've got this space. I've got this really sunny space that is a waste. I want to try this. And so in June, which is way too late where I live, in June, I was planting potatoes. And they came out all right.
Yeah.
You know, for late potatoes, they were great. I did fava beans.
I'd say the rule for potatoes is to have them in the ground by St. Patrick's Day.
Yep.
Yeah.
And peas by President's Day.
Okay.
Yeah, so I'll be doing peas soon.
Yep.
So that book changed my life. And there's a lot in there about they did a trip to Italy and discovered a specific kind of pumpkin that I actually had out there. It didn't grow last year. So
a really ugly pumpkin.
Yeah.
Yeah.
So, yeah, that's what got me started was this book. It absolutely changed my life.
Yeah. Yeah, it's great to listen to an audio. If you get the book card back or whatever, that's great too. But the audio, Barbara Kingsolver narrates it so well that you get her intention through her voice. So I loved it. I was happy to share it with you.
Yeah, thank you.
You're welcome.
Because I listen to it 3 times a year. So I listen to it when I'm starting the seeds indoors and then when I'm prepping the beds out there, the garden beds. And then when I'm putting the garden beds to bed for the season. So 3 times a year I listen to it. It's that good, y'all. So that's
it's good.
That.
Yeah.
Thank you for introducing me to that.
So you're welcome.
Let's see who what's going on here. That's differently a different ASMR. I'm thinking that's the school.
Right, yeah. Right.
Ari, thanks for coming. It's good to see you, pal. And yeah, you can get the book right here. It's good. And you know, I actually encourage people don't buy books if you don't have to. Your local library should have it, but if you just can't wait and you're that excited, and let me tell you, it's worth it. There's your link. So,
yeah.
Do you want to do anything else? Are we good?
Let's
do you
try that.
Try this milky one?
Yeah.
All right. Do you want new glasses or?
Yeah. I don't want
to. You don't want to mix?
I don't want to interfere one with another.
Okay. Does anyone have any other questions? Hey, girl, thanks for coming.
So they say it's best to let this sit at least overnight, the milky one.
Uh-huh.
But, you know, what do they know? We're going
well,
for
they
it.
Probably, who is they, first of all?
I don't know.
Which one are you pouring?
Try that
this one.
This one? Yeah. So
isn't there?
Oh, we've got a little extra here.
Yeah. Here. This will be fun, y'all. Yeah, let's do this in the money shot.
We could just drink it out of the barrel here.
I don't need a face full. Drink.
This one, yours or mine?
Keep going. Just dump it. You're good. All right. Oh, you're giving me the big one.
Oh, if you want, yeah. Salute.
Is there some vanilla in there?
Oh, there's a little bit of vanilla bean. Vanilla sugar. made with fresh vanilla beans. Yeah.
Excuse me.
Sorry.
Entertain our guests.
We love our Bichons. But they do have a voice.
That's enough.
We're thinking there might be an Amazon delivery or something like that. Something. It could be another big rat.
Oh my God. Sorry.
You didn't hear that from me.
It was out in the pasture, y'all.
Right before we came on.
It was out in the pasture.
We were out chasing a rat.
Oh, this is good. This is really good. But does anyone have questions? Wow, that vanilla is coming through.
Yeah, that's nice.
That's that vanilla that Sheri had.
Yes, Sheri gave you that vanilla sugar.
Yeah. And then, yeah.
Yeah, so that's going to be good really cold. I like it really cold.
So yeah, right now it's kind of warm cereal-ish, kind of.
Yeah.
You know what it reminds me
yeah,
of?
Yeah, your Cheerios with the sugar in the bottom of the bowl.
No, not the Lucky Cheerios. The Fruit Loops.
Oh, no, mine was Cheerios, but, you know.
No, this reminds me of Fruit Loops juice. All right. Any questions, folks? We're gonna drink here in front of you and make you feel bad for a few more seconds, and then we're gonna let you go.
Well, this was fun. Thank you for inviting me. I'm honored to be your very first guest.
Thank you for coming. Wow, the guest thing was interesting. I'm glad it was you for the first one. I'm super, super honored that you came.
I needed more limoncello. So, and this was, you know, this spurred me on. So
it's about the alcohol for her.
Well, you know, I'm a lush.
Okay, what are there any other uses for the creme de limoncello?
No, it's just a drink. As far as I know, that's all I've ever seen. It's just a drink.
So maybe we need to invent a cocktail or find one to use with it.
We could.
You know, I could see this mixed in with...
It's very smooth.
I could see it with pound cake, a little lemon curd.
Oh, yeah.
And then drizzled on.
Especially if you have it cold, because it'll thicken up and get viscous.
Viscous.
My favorite word.
Yeah, but... Yeah. Oh, Sheri, here you go.
I can't read it without my glasses.
Keely says you were fantastic.
Oh.
And put the fire emoji behind it. She never does that for me. Just drink it. Just drink it. Bread pudding. Yeah.
Tori.
Damn.
There you go.
Snap.
Woo.
Yes. Yeah.
Oh.
Drizzle that on some bread pudding. We're down.
Oh, yeah.
You know, I have some bread. What are you doing tonight?
I can get pudding. That's not good.
I have some far fresh eggs. And we've got lemon milk. We've got milk. Shit. I think I know what we're doing tonight.
Yeah. Because I'm not driving real soon. So.
There you go, folks.
Thanks, Tori.
Thanks, Tori. Limoncello milkshake.
Oh, you know, that sounds that's great. A good
Except, you know, great. All we have is Biscoff ice cream.
Oh. Could be fabulous. Could be fabulous.
We might leave this stream going after. No. All right. Anything else? Let's see if I missed anybody. I just want to make sure because we had some new people coming up today. Ari, thank you for coming again. I appreciate it. Nicole, Adam, who are also the new ones, Vincent. If you enjoy this, go check out some more. Please subscribe, like, do the little bell thing, all the things.
If any of our Bichon friends are out there and, you know, didn't want to jump on the chat, that's great, but we appreciate you tuning in.
Yes.
We really do.
Yes.
We all have lives outside of our dogs. Not much of a life, but, you know, a little bit of a life.
So. I have a little more of a life.
But we really appreciate you tuning in. More than I can say.
Yeah. Next week will be a pre-recorded video that I'll drop at 4 p.m. Pacific. And then the week after that, I'm moving to 5 p.m.
Because we're going to be at a dog show.
Yes.
Because that's what we do.
Yes. Yes. All right. Thank you all. I appreciate you. Oh, limoncello yogurt. Dang.
What?
Limoncello yogurt.
Oh.
Yes. And hit that like button on your way out, y'all. If you haven't hit that subscribe button, please do that. It helps a ton. Take care, everyone. Good night.
See ya.